This is a public disservice message from the National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Never send care packages to the so-called starving families in Europe, because they're not starving at all. Can you afford to live in Europe? No. You can't even afford to visit Europe. And do you know what they do with the care packages you send? They whack them with their polo mallets and kick them into their swimming pools and have a good laugh at your expense.
Good evening, and welcome to Alternative Child. You know, a lot of people have been taking a long, hard look at our school system, and after taking that look, they're saying, no thanks. That's not for me or my child. Tonight we have a man who's offering an alternative, the head of the Lombardi Institute, Dr. Howard Bear Barnes. Dr. Barnes, could you tell us about your school and what it has to offer?
Certainly, Lloyd. We're located on 520 wooded acres outside Fond du Lac, Wisconsin. We have live-in accommodations for 7,000 boys and girls from ages 2 years to 5 years.
And you're dealing strictly with preschool children, is that correct?
That's correct. While being too young for elementary school, these children from ages 2 to 5 are not too young to begin physical development. Some people think that a child at 2 or 3 is too young for strenuous physical exercise. This is simply not true. I got 2 and 3-year-olds who can do 100-yard wind sprints all afternoon. I got 1 2-year-old that can do 5,000 sit-ups.
So the children are actually in training?
All the time. They eat at a training table, and each day they receive instructions for 8 hours, and they practice for 8 hours in football, basketball, track, swimming, hockey, karate, kung fu, and Thai boxing. At the age of 4, each child must pass a survival test. In this test, we drop them by parachute over the Sierra Nevada mountains with nothing but a Swiss Army knife. They must make their way in the woods for 20 days and walk 100 miles to Reno, where we pick them up.
Well, what do you find is the biggest problem with kids this age?
I'd say knee injuries and shoulder separations. There's still a lot we don't know about knee injuries. All we can do is operate when possible. Otherwise, we just tape it up.
What about the drug problem, Bear?
Well, we don't issue pep pills or any kind of drugs to the children. We leave it up to their own discretion. We know that some of them use them, but we don't encourage it. We'll give them a painkiller now and then, but that's about all.
I see you brought along 2 of the children from the Institute.
Yes, this is Debbie Ferguson from Santa Clara, California. Debbie wants to be a dental hygienist, as Debbie puts it, to help people. Debbie is 4 years old, 2'7.5" tall, 120 pounds. She won a bronze medal in Munich, and last week she swam 200 miles upstream in the Columbia River.
Hi, Debbie.
This is Jimmy Dugan. Jimmy hails from Cottonmouth, Mississippi, and when he grows up, he wants to be a sharecropper, just like Dad. Jimmy is 3.5 years old. He stands 2'3", 185 pounds. He's got good speed. He does 109.3. Look at those calves, Lloyd. He's a good boy up front. He can go long. He's good deep. He'll get you inside. He'll get you outside. And he's tough on the option. He's a tough boy. Likes to hit. And he's not afraid to get his uniform dirty. Jimmy's recovering from some hockey injuries. He took 105 stitches across his face, and he lost his left ear. He's a tough boy. He's a fierce competitor. He's got poise, confidence, and he wants to win. I think he's going to be one of the all-time greats. In spite of the injury, he's in top physical condition. If we might demonstrate this, Lloyd, I want you to haul off and punch Jimmy in the stomach just as hard as you can. Go on, just punch him.
Me? No, I couldn't do that. He's only a child.
Of course you can. He can take it really hard now. Come on, punch him.
Well, okay. Oh, did I hurt him? Is he all right?
He's not hurt. Come on, get up. Shake it off. Come on, crybaby, stand up. Lloyd, hit him again.
But he's crying.
Hit him again, I said. He can take it. Hit him.
All right.